Kate. Sorry, I came off a little strong there. What kind of a person do you think I am?
You're going to hell, I can tell you that much.
Okay, that's probably fair. And that maybe what everyone else is kind of assumed about my personality, too. I asked this because I recently sent a bunch of people TikToks. I mean, I send TikToks pretty frequently, except to you, because you don't ever watch them if I send them to you.
I'm just never opening TikTok.
If they're not hamster-related, you won't watch them.
I just never open TikTok.
So I send it to other people who actually care about me and what I like and how I feel. And I sent a TikTok of this very lovely song by an artist called, I think it's Low Spirit. It's like L-O, but the O has a cross slash.
I think I know who you're talking about, though.
But the song is a very sweet song, and it just came out recently. And the TikTok I sent was him explaining that this song he wrote is about parents who want to protect their children, but no matter what you do to protect them from the world, you realize they're going to find all of the ugly things in it eventually. And so I sent this song to a couple of my parent friends, thinking they would also like this song, thinking it's a lovely song that all parents can relate to, even myself, who happens to occasionally be a jackass. Well, not once, but twice of two of these, I don't know, maybe three or four parents that I sent this video to said, well, that was a lovely song, but that's not what I expected coming from you. So I wanted to know what exactly it is about me that people don't assume that there's going to be something sweet and nice and touching and that it's going to be something in different entirely.
Because you're going to hell.
So because I'm going to hell, everything I touch has to be good.
It usually is.
That's the solution. That's the answer. I can't have a tender side to me because, you know what? When you roast meat, it becomes tender after a while of roasting it.
But you're not being roasted. You're doing the roasting.
I just wanted to know what kind of, and you know what other kind of person I am. I'm drinking a Four Loko on a Sunday night when I gotta get up at 6 a.m. for work, and that's you. That's your fault. This didn't used to happen. I wasn't this person before you.
You have to be up in 11 hours and 43 minutes. I think you're fine.
You did the math on it?
It's 6:17. 12 hours minus 17.
Are you good?
I got the hiccups. Leave me be.
This is going to be a bad start already. Alright, I just wanted to get that out there and put a feel out for why people assume this about me. That if they're going to receive a TikTok involving a song, it's not about to be, you know, I don't know, living La Vida pussy or something.
I mean, I guess it's like me and your wife today, and her keep asking me what's wrong because I've got extreme resting bitch face that she has apparently never seen from me before.
Well, that's gonna fix your RBF. And then you're gonna be cackling the whole night, and then she's gonna be upset that you're useless to her.
I told her to just have dinner done by the time we're done, and the food will help.
I don't think she's going to have it done.
Especially the rice.
She's still sitting on her computer. We're going to be starving all night. Bring back tacos.
I told her that this wasn't going to be an easy thing if I'm hungry and drunk, and I don't have food when we're done.
All right, well, if I'm going to hell, and that's what everyone expects of me, then I'm ready to take the rest of you fuckers with me. You ready?
I'm already going to hell.
Awesome. Let's bring everyone else down with us then.
Let's do it.
Let's go. Gather round, we've got stories to tell. How the human race should be erased from space. We're horrible people and deserve to die. If you don't believe me, then I'll tell you why. We've caused genocides and mass extinction. Humans causing bad pollution. Amazon is burning down. California's on shaky ground. Ted Cruz in Cancun, people deny the moon. Gun crime is on the rise, hypocrisy and evil lies. Leadership is on vacation, God is doing tax evasion. Police increasing jurisdiction, overdue for extinction. Welcome back to Overdue for Extinction, the podcast where we set out the proof every day of our goddamn lives that the human race is overdue for an extinction-level event. I am Anthony, only because nobody is searching for me, so I'm safe to be myself.
And I'm Kate. No, my last name changed recently.
Your last name did change recently.
It did.
I don't even know what your last name is.
Baker.
Oh, I didn't know that was a last name. You had so much potential to change it to so many things.
When Willard and I get married, that's the plan.
Kristen, when I thought I heard a cat hiss. I was like,
what's no, my nose has been clogged all day.
Oh, it's just your nose. You and I are perpetually sick. We can't shake it. I have this ear congestion which keeps popping and giving me varying levels of hearing capability. And you've got nasal congestion. I wake up nasally a little bit.
Oh my god, I wake up with the worst cough, especially because it gets so cold down in the basement.
That's kind of my fault, because when we go to bed at night, it gets to 68 and low. When it gets to 68, it shuts off the air, and then our room gets really hot. So I just turn it to on instead of auto, and then when I wake up in the morning, it's like 64 degrees in the house.
Murder you. I go to bed shivering and I wake up shivering even more. I told Kristen that you guys are penguins.
You just have to go to bed dressed tighter than a nun's asshole.
You guys just need to change your last name to Penguin.
Well, we discussed our last name change potentially when we were getting married, because I don't really like Hockenberry. It's just kind of like a weird, harsh German name. And she didn't like Benner. Because she didn't like the family association with it. So I said, well, this is an opportunity. We could both change our names to something else. And I just threw some really off the wall ones. I said, we could kind of stick to my name a little bit and be like the Hockenlukers. And she didn't like that either, so.
Willard had a teacher at one point his last name was Dragon. But
he definitely got that changed.
I never liked my last name due to family, of course. He's never liked his last name for similar reasons. So when we get married, we're just going to take a whole new last name.
You should have just jumped the gun. And then you could have had all the power and made him take your last name.
In Ohio, you can't.
That's some bullshit.
In Ohio, a man cannot take his partner's last name. So what do you do if you're gay?
I guess you just...
Gotta come up with a new name.
Well, it's in Ohio, so they're fighting to change that too. But we won't touch that today. We're not here for politics.
The one main thing, though, is the fact that weed is on the ballot.
Yes, that is indeed.
Vote yes, issue 2, Tuesday.
That's what I'm going out tomorrow to do. So, though our names may be remotely the same, partially changed, we are the same jackasses that do the same bullshit every week for you, and this week will be no different. Kate, you want to know what's on our ballot this week?
Absolutely.
Me too. I don't have anything prepped.
We did this last time.
I don't know if it was last time, but we definitely did it one time recently.
I definitely think it was last time. I want to say it was for the bonus episode.
Because I said, I've got one article that I thought was really cool. We're going to do that one. And then I brought it up and then found out the article was locked behind a paywall. So we didn't have that article anymore. And then I've got like other things kind of floating in the air. They're just like, let's just grab. Yeah, that'll make an episode.
That's what we did for the bonus episode. And in fact, like, we kind of cut the bonus episode short because you said bonus episodes were still going to be 5 segments. And we only did 3 segments because you weren't prepared.
I don't know. I think it was okay. I think it was 5, but it was still an hour because we did shorter segments. But it's neither here nor there. We got it together.
We didn't do 5. We set it up for 3.
I've got it all up here. I'm the mastermind of all of this, so I will guide us through the dark valley of dumb.
Help me!
What I do know is we're going to talk about a interesting competition that I didn't know about before last week. It's really more of a competition that people participate in unknowingly, that they're participating in it when they're trying to show off. We'll get into that.
Like the game? You just lost. You all just lost. I just lost.
There go all of the views that we ever were going to have for this episode. And the podcast is dead now because of you.
Because I just made everyone lose the game.
So, we're going to talk about that. A listener, Faith, as we discussed her last week, finally subscribed to the Patreon.
Faith!
We bullied her into it. And she also sent in some voice clips of a story. So we're going to do a drunken lullaby story verse.
We're going to listen to one of Faith's stories, finally.
We are. And I haven't listened to them in full before, so it's going to be a surprise for all of us.
Oh, God.
And then the third segment we're going to do is one of my new favorites, is the social media saviors. So strap in. It's going to be fun, even though it's going to be kind of unplanned and a wild card. Not the wild card that you hate. We won't go back into ARC. That's a whole other... If I get you talking about ARC, we're never going to get back to this again. So,
I will stop talking about ARK if you promise to try ASA when it comes out on PlayStation.
If it ever comes out.
Well, you know what you could do? You could try it from Game Pass. Like, sign in to Xbox with Kristen's account and try it on your PC when it comes out and she gets it.
We'll see. Since I have you guys to make me a god mode file.
Look, man, you have to talk to your wife about that.
I don't pay a Patreon fee. I pay a dick slanging fee, and that gets me whatever I want.
You can tribe up with Willard.
I can try dick slanging with Willard?
Tribe up with Willard.
What?
I almost said Dickard.
Dickard? That's his new name now, is Dickard. You have to call him that.
No! He is the Willard.
Alright, well, let's go ahead and get started then. And we'll discuss terms and conditions of my godhood later.
Okay. All
right. We're going to kick things off this week with, now that's what I call sports.
Hey, man, welcome to the pad.
Ha sick. You got a couple of lazy boys? Food spread? I'm ready to watch the game.
Yeah, for sure, man. Just have a seat. I'll grab us a couple beers.
Why are we watching a bunch of people toe wrestle?
Isn't it great? Now that's what I call sports.
Alright, so this week's sports segment. Have you ever heard of siren battles?
No.
Do you know what a siren is? Not the loud tornadoes are coming to
fuck
your shit up.
You're talking about the mermaids. Yes. Yes.
Okay, so you are familiar with sirens. This has nothing to do with them.
Do you not remember the conversation I had with your oldest about sirens?
No.
In the living room?
No.
Because I asked him why he didn't read fairy tales, and he said they're lame and boring, and I said not the original fairy tales.
I'm going to be 100% honest. I did not listen to any. I heard the conversation happening, but I just checked out of all of it.
Yeah, I explained to him that The Little Mermaid wasn't about mermaids. It was actually about sirens.
Indeed it is. All right, let's get started.
You're just agreeing to shut me up.
I would never do that to you, Kate.
Bitch! And that is why you're called Ginger Bitch.
So, in New Zealand, there are these activities going on called siren battles. Based on that information alone, let me ask you, what do you think these siren battles pertain to
in New Zealand? Something about singing.
You think about singing?
Yeah.
Do you think they're having just regular, that's not what I call music, that's an actual music album. They're having a New Zealand's Got Talent sing-off?
Kinda. What's that Netflix show where they, dress up as characters and you don't know who it is and they're
The Masked
dancing?
Singer?
Yeah, singing, yes.
When they're dancing?
I don't know.
They probably do that, too.
Dancing. But yes, something like that, but not in costumes, but singing, of course, because that's what sirens are. They are known for luring men to the bottom of the sea with their voices by singing.
I think all they do is show their titties, and that's good enough. I'd jump ship.
But the half tail, half fish?
Look, I'll figure out the logistics of it later, so long as I can get my hand on those hand-sized honkers.
Redonkulous.
New Zealanders are blasting Celine Dion from their car speakers until 3 a.m., leaving some miserable, says the headline of today's That's What I Call Sports. Let's get into it. So, groups of young people cruise the streets of, why do I ever do anything foreign? Porirua, New Zealand, in the dead of night, their cars and bicycles stacked with high-powered speakers designed to emit the loudest, clearest sounds. The groups known as siren clubs use late-night musical battles to express their identities and create community. As they blare songs through speakers that normally top emergency alert towers or police cruisers, they compete for the title of Siren King. So naturally you would think, well, they must have a designated time for this. This is surely a point of the day where nobody is being bothered by these loud noises, other than the occasional noise complaint. Right? No? You don't believe that?
What about street racing? That's never planned at, normal hours.
Well, you also don't want to be arrested during street racing, so you typically don't do that during the point.
But if you're in the wrong area, even here, if you go to Poland, and your car alone, your muffler is too loud, they will ticket you.
Okay, that's fair enough. But apparently in New Zealand, they don't give a fuck. So, How They Play It is a popular sound in the fight for the title, prized for its pitch and purity. It is the voice of Celine Dion. But hearing the singer known as the Queen of Power Ballads late into the night is driving some Perura citizens crazy. The mayor, Anita Baker, said she is hearing an increasing number of residents complain about the pulsating noise that reverberates through their neighborhoods as late as 3 a.m. Could you imagine trying to be asleep at 3 a.m., dead asleep in La La Land, and you're just enjoying your rest, and then you just hear, and we always love you.
Look at that, look at that.
Yeah, no, Karen's going to love that. I hope she can lessen that for the viewers. That's going to hurt.
Well, it wasn't Celine Dion, but when I lived in Warren, I had many nights where I was woken up by yelling at random times of the night.
I think that's just called gang violence.
No,
or domestic violence. Well, those have very specific names that aren't sports by the means.
The house, like, if you were in the house and looking out towards the street, the house to the left, families were in and out of that the entire time we were there. And the one lady got locked out. So, like, somewhere between 1 and 3 in the morning, she's out there banging on all the windows and all the doors and yelling loud enough that it woke me up in my room. I'm out of shit. But if you go across the street and two houses down, there was a couple that was always fighting, and you could always hear him yelling as he walks down the street yelling at her.
That absolutely sounds like domestic violence. And maybe a drug den or two.
It was more like...
Where you hail from, that's entirely possible.
yeah, but you could tell that it was relationship bullshit. Like, why are you doing this? Why are you kicking me out?
Some Eminem Rihanna shit.
It was a big mess. And I don't know why they kept getting back together, but it was always the same dude, too.
Love the Way You Lie is the white trash domestic violence anthem, and I'm here for it. I love it so much. So the mayor goes on to say that these noise complaints at 3 a.m. are understandable, and while the more organized groups have agreed to work with the city officials and stop their music at 10 p.m., a smaller breakaway faction has kept pumping sirens into the wee hours. So we got some jackasses that will not abide by the 10 p.m. curfew. Which means up to 10 p.m., you might be hearing a lot of motherfuckers blasting Celine Dion from their car speakers. But not even their car speakers, it sounds like people stack on the back of their bikes, too. Which seems like it's a really hazardous way to travel, as it's going to make you extremely top-heavy and probably unbalanced. So, Baker told the Washington Post they don't follow the rules and they're just making it hell for people. Siren clubs are made up mostly of young men, many of them in Porirua's Pacific Islander community, known as Pacifica. They get together to modify cars and bicycles with public address system speakers, which they call sirens. They spend hours wiring and soldering multiple sirens and amplifiers to car frames or onto bicycles. Before battling, they must also become DJs, remixing songs with the goal of producing a sound that is not only loud, but also clean. So this is a real, like, this is a real challenge, real throwdown. You gotta be a good DJ to make your beat sound fresh as fuck.
I have good car shit. Misled me by asking about sirens and not the wee-woo kind.
I'm sorry that you haven't expected this by now. Remember, what was it I misled you about last week?
Bitch! You think I remember?
You remember the things that don't fucking matter.
Sadly.
I don't remember those.
I don't remember anything about our episodes, really.
You could just listen to it and be like, wow, that's an interesting take.
The only thing I do remember is when you made the comment about we could have hot dogs for dinner because we could have hot dogs and have dinner and calculate pie. And Kristen was like, what? I'm like, do you not remember the WikiHow and hot dog down a hallway? And she goes, oh.
And you always remember the fart bag cold open.
Only because you were dying more than I were. Was?
Were.
What?
Were was?
I don't know
if it's the brain cancer or the alcohol at this point.
Probably both.
Okay, fair enough. So strong voices with a high pitch are favored, Baker said. Dion's My Heart Will Go On and The Power of Love, and the boo. The Power of Love are Siren Club classics. Sia's Chandelier is also a go-to, Baker added. Then the sirens do battle. The Siren Clubs often sneak into a train station or a private parking lot. Oh, there's even rules to it, too. A member of the Siren Club has spoken up and said, any distortion or reverberation will make you lose. Celine Dion is popular, so we try to use music that is high treble, is clear, and not much bass. Reggae is our go-to as it has a nice beats and doesn't sound distorted. There's some highfalutin rules to this competition. They go on to tell you who was last year's champion and all this and that. The battles outlived the World Cup festivities and continued throughout the summer, Baker said. They abated a bit over the winter, but never died out and have now reemerged as summer in New Zealand approaches. So now there's a petition going around on change.org, which more than 325 people have signed to stop the gathering of cars to meet and blasting music and emergency siren noises all through the night. 325 doesn't seem like very much. I don't know what the population of this town is, let alone the population of New Zealand, but that seems like a pretty small amount for people who are upset that people are blasting music at 3 a.m.
New Zealand's population is 5.123 million as of 2021. What's the town?
The town is called Porirua. P-O-R-I-R-U-A.
I-U-A?
Is that it? Porirua. O-I-R-U-A. New Zealand.
Estimated population of 62,400 as of June 2023, with population density of 357 people per kilometer.
So all of those people that live there, only 371 per kilometer stop this per music. Squared.
Per kilometer squared. What? I don't know how that came out.
Per square kilometer? You okay with that?
No. Alright. I thought I said kilometer per squared. And I'm like, wait, no. I might have. Only Karen can tell us at this point.
Baker says it's really frustrating and she feels powerless.
I didn't say any of that.
I could still be playing Baldur's Gate.
You're the one that wanted to go to weekly episodes.
The mayor said that even though the subculture grew out of the Pacifica community, she hopes it doesn't get blamed for what she described as a handful of bad actors turning a positive community celebration into a nuisance. I would say she's not powerless. I say you show up with that or to one of those meetings with a fucking rocket launcher. I feel like they're going to listen to you pretty well. You show up with an EMP and you fucking blast everyone's shit, make all that gear useless. I ain't gonna listen.
Don't even need to do that. You just need to.
Oh, this will be good.
Show up with a shit ton, please. I'm sorry. A thought just crossed my mind and I had to stop myself from running out real quick.
Okay.
I don't know why you said EMP, but it made me think of UFO, and it made me want to go see if the UFO was in the sky tonight. Because Kristen thinks it's a neighbor's light.
I think it's something completely reasonable when you're...
It moved.
The aliens aren't coming for nobody here. We're all too fucked mentally. We'd be bad specimen for their probing.
According to Bones... And the stories my parents used to tell me, they only took children because children taste like chicken.
I wish they would fucking take children. It'd be a little bit cheaper around here. A little bit quieter. So that's really about it. It goes on to explain the cost of what these speakers are. Not really relevant at all. But they are hoping that these breakaway groups will fall back in line and start doing the 10 p.m. curfew so everybody can sleep happily.
Good luck with that.
It seems like a really weird thing. People don't make anything a competition anymore. I mean, I wonder what the weirdest competition out there is. You think people are like, well, I say people. It could be people. Women could be included too. But do you think that men primarily are having pissing distance contests?
Weirdest competitions from sources across the web. Wife carrying? Extreme ironing, Cooper's Hill Cheese Rolling and Wake. I've seen a video about that. That's pretty funny.
I covered that one with Russ, I think it was.
There was a series on Netflix that did a whole episode about it, and that's where I saw it. Chess boxing, we covered that.
Sure did.
Bog snorkeling. How could you see anything if you're snorkeling in a bog?
Maybe that's the point, but that's how you find bodies, too, because people throw bodies into a bog because the bog's...
That's how you get eaten by alligators, too.
That's probably also happened.
Air guitar world championships.
That's a bunch of lonely nerds living in their mom's basement.
Mobile phone throwing.
That seems like a waste of money.
Swamp football. World beard and mustache champion. International Birdman, World Pea Shooting Championships, World's Ugliest Dog Contest, World Sauna Championships, Great Knaresboro Bed Race, Rolling in the Grits Contest, and Totnes Orange Race.
I feel like there's a good possibility Karen will insert a 1 hour later
post than that. We're done. Promise, that was it.
Shit.
You know, chess boxing and the cheese roll wasn't even, like, high up there either.
I believe there might actually be a pissing contest. I'm going to have to research this and we'll have to talk about it if it is. I also feel like if I search pissing contest, I'm not going to come across a news story where two men got into a fight and were having a, you know, pissing contest. Or I'm going to get into some weird form of Pornhub that's going to take me down some real dark channels. You look at me like you know the shit ain't on the web. People like golden showers, bitch. I didn't invent it.
People also like fake semen, okay? You don't know this story?
What about fake semen?
So back when we first started selling the squirting dildos...
Uh-huh.
Not us as a podcast, but her,
the adult store.
You could put anything in it. You could put water, you could put lube. But the biggest thing that we were asked for, because we had it, and like the company sold it at some point, was fake semen. It was basically just cloudy... kind of chunky from what I was told.
You probably could make that with like cornstarch and water.
You don't want to put certain things up there, but yes, people are totally using it.
Hey, you can't tell some people not to put some things up there. They will do it anyway.
Apparently. Apparently.
Alright, well,
people are fucking nasty.
So that's our sports segment of the week. I would much rather prefer that than any basketball game where I have to listen to squealing of sneakers the entire time. I don't know how you feel about squealing of sneakers, but it's not my thing.
Oh, you mean the squeak that they do when they're wet and you're walking on hard floors?
Yeah, that. Or just them running down the court squeaking the entire time. I can't watch basketball.
You know what was so satisfying, though? You know the scuff marks that the shoes make?
Okay.
Just rubbing them off is so satisfying to me.
Just the weirdest things that make you happy.
I like the smell of gas, whatever.
A lot. I also enjoy the smell of gasoline, but...
You know what apparently that means?
Probably something mentally fucked with us.
That we were burned at the stake in a previous life as witches.
I fully believe that. If my previous lives were anything like I am today, they got absolutely burned.
Well, that's like... Mom keeps telling me I have this very bright red spot, like, redder than your hair. It goes from, like, this side to this side. So she swears up and down that I was shot with an arrow in a past life. Because it just goes straight through, and I only have those two spots.
I think we should shave your head now to find out.
You don't need to shave my head. You just need to wait until my roots grow out. And then I'll have Kristen find this side, because it's brighter than this side.
Which means
this is the entry point side.
I'm not interested in waiting. I want to know now. So we're going to shave your head.
If shaving my head won't do anything.
I'll see the red spot.
No, you won't. Just wait until my roots grow out a bit, and then I'll have Kristen show you.
No. Next episode, we're shaving Kate's head.
No, we're not. Not unless you're going to buy me some nice-ass wigs, and those are a pretty penny that neither of us can afford right now.
All right, fair enough. Well, let's move on then from sirens to book writers who write about sirens. I don't know if she writes about sirens, or is she all about vampires?
I know she's written about werewolves. I don't know. I've looked into her books and I want to read them, but I don't know what all she writes about. I know she has a space one going too.
I know she writes some
interesting as fuck, honestly.
Dirty shit.
But like,
she's writing supernatural smut, and I say that in the most respectable way.
It seems really good, though. I'm just waiting until I can actually buy her books, A, because I can't read on Kindle, and B, because I want to support a good friend. And I love her so much, and I'm not even that drunk, so I actually mean that.
So I'm not drunk.
I really do love her.
I'm not drunk loving you. I'm just regular loving you, so you know it's legit.
She's fantastic. Thank you for bringing her into our lives. I think Kristen and I enjoy her.
So Faith, I've known for actually almost two decades. I've been 34. I met her when I was 14. Through the power of internet dating, because you know you had to have an online boyfriend or girlfriend, you were alone for the rest of your life, just living out here like lonely spinsters in the Middle Ages.
Regardless, love her.
But Faith is a wonderful author. I kind of mock her about her. Her work being supernatural smut.
But to be fair, that is one of the most high, like, most in-demand genres right now. Even, like, even if she were to write a book and go post it on Amazon with no editor, not her boss, nothing. Like, if she did that, she could still probably make a good buck because it is really, really high in demand.
Possibly, yes. I'm not real familiar with that side of the population, or at least not that I know. People probably don't feel comfortable telling people that's what they read. But in any case,
I've read some, but like it's also research and
research.
No, do you know that I enjoy writing? And at one point, I did want to be an author.
You got ample time; you could write now.
I don't have ample time, but I do want to get back into writing. But yes, I have looked into what genres are more in demand, so where I could make money quicker.
So, for anyone curious, her pen name is Eva Kingsley, in case you're interested in looking at her information, her books. She did ask us...
Did you have permission to share both names?
You know what? I'm going... Well, I said Faith. I didn't say Faith who. So... So if you are interested in supernatural smut, as it were, you might want to check her out on
Amazon. From what I have read, she is really good.
So I have problems with myself going back to what people think of me. And when somebody tells me, hey, here's something I've done or something I'm looking at, tell me what you think of it. I can't just be like, yeah, it looks great. I have to be the person that finds a way to cut them out of pure jest and love. I don't do it to be malicious, but I do it. And so she sent us in this group chat the back of her book cover, and the book says, when Ember receives an SOS from Earth, there's no hesitation. They're a protector. This is what they do. It's not until they land on Earth that they realize everything they've been told is a lie. Anya wanted a normal, quiet life, but the day the aliens land on her land, all her plans are thrown into the four winds. Meeting Ember throws her simple life into a raging chaos. Their connection is instant and undeniable. Their chemistry out of this world. Will Ember succeed in their rescue mission? Will Anya be able to let go of the past and embrace the future? Only fate knows, and only time will tell. The spicy gender fluid sci-fi romance will snatch your soul and hold your attention captive. The pages burn with passion and desire, and so will you. And being who I am, she asked the group, what do we think? And I had no choice but to say, it's horny Doctor Who. Which she didn't appreciate. She said it's nothing like Doctor Who. And I said, a gender-fluid alien protecting Earth, throwing an unexpected companion to be in life's... throwing an unexpected companion to be's life in chaos. I don't know. So she didn't like my opinion. You guys defended her, called me a dumbass, I'm sure.
Yes. I mean, honestly, I might read that, and I really do want to read her werewolf books, because, like, I read J.R. Ward, and J.R. Ward writes about vampires. She writes damn good books. I read Gina Showalter, her Lords of the Underworld series, where it's basically a Pandora's Box series. But they're, like, those were good, too. And, like I said, from what I've read from her, it's really freaking good. So I kind of really want to read that werewolf series.
Well, if you guys are interested in supporting a good friend and this genre sounds like your kind of thing, check out Eva Kingsley's Alien Seduction.
And I promise, she's a really good writer.
She's got a bunch of other books like this as well. So in that same vein, thank you, Faith, for being a patron and supporting us. We're still not at our goal to get out of this lovely garage that we're in.
Where we love you, though.
It's like 50 degrees outside, so if we could get a couple more patrons going before it's winter, we'd be good.
I keep doing that because I can see my breath. But, like, where my sweater is, I'm not cold enough to put back on my jacket yet. I totally forgot these sweaters were this nice.
So let's get into this week's Drunken Lullabies.
Hey! Watch me do a handstand!
Alright, we got one of her messages. We'll save the rest for our future episodes. But we'll go ahead and get these going now.
I'll preface this by saying that after a 6-hour blowjob, I no longer like dicks anywhere near my mouth. Okay. So I was about 20 years old, and I was living with my roommate, and she got all the sexual attention. Everybody was about her, and it made me so freaking jealous. Like, she was getting laid almost every single night by somebody different, and I wasn't getting any, but I still had to listen to it. It was irritating. And anyway, this new guy started where we work, and he was very attractive, and you know, in a kind of boy next door kind of way. But for whatever reason, all her advances towards him got denied. He was not interested. And then one day he came up to me and asked me out to dinner. And I was like, what? In the end, we didn't have time for that. And I invited him over to my house instead, in which he informed me that he would like me to perform sexual stuff on him. And I told him that I didn't really want to do that because, you know, my friend has feelings for him. But in the end, I agreed to. We decided it was going to be a threesome thing. And so the blowjob began, and he wasn't showing my friend any attention. She was trying to kiss him, and he was just, like, pushing her away, and it was bad. And so she gave up, and she went to her bedroom, and he begged me to continue. And like I said, I haven't been laid in a long time at this point, so I went on with it, thinking that, you know, I just got to get him off and then he'll get me off. It's simple, you know? But no, I kept doing the things, mouth, breast, you know, lap dance, whatever you could think of, for 6 hours. And this guy never orgasmed, never came. And then when the sun came up, he was like, I think I should go now. And I was like, are you kidding me? Needless to say, I never spoke to him again, though he tried, and my jaw hurt for over a week. And I feel like a complete idiot.
Did he ever come out as gay?
I was going to say, it reminds me of that woman who wanted to bring another man into the bedroom, and she was worried about losing him to another woman. It's like, oh, honey, you don't have to worry about losing him to another woman.
It reminds me a lot of asshole. You know, he wanted blowjobs, he wanted anal, but he didn't want anything else. And, like,
some questions were raised. 6 hours.
Everyone still swears he's gay.
Okay, so you put in 6 hours of work. You put in a full shift, as far as I'm concerned, and you didn't get any payout for that matter, and that is problematic as fuck. 6 hours. Goddamn, 6 hours is more work than some people put into anything in their entire lives. Not Baldur's Gate. I'm like 240 hours deep, balls deep into that, and you don't see
me. Yeah, he gotta be real gay. He didn't even orgasm once.
Oh, and he's pushing the other girl away. She was trying to kiss him.
I know. Gotta be real gay.
I 6 hours.
Like, I mean, I can kind of understand. Like, I have had, you know, hookups where they didn't want to kiss. I get that.
That's some prostitute rule shit.
But, like...
I don't know if I should tell you. Go on.
I don't want to hear much times for prostitutes.
No, nothing with prostitutes, just your sister.
I don't think I want to hear that either. She knows too much about me right now. So.
Look, I was going to say, it's not like it's any surprise. We have living examples of our escapades.
I know you do.
I was just going to say, there was one point where we hooked up the night before and she had to go somewhere in the morning. And she slipped out of bed and I didn't notice that she had left for the day or whatever. And I woke up to Millie being next to me instead. And I texted her and I said, I didn't even hear you get out of bed. She said, yeah, I guess I rolled a natural 20 on my stealth check. You know, I'm a big fucking nerd, so she's got to use my language.
She told me about that this morning.
Nah, okay. I wasn't going to tell you it was today.
She slipped out of bed and you texted her and her response to it. She was so proud of herself.
Yeah, and I told her, you didn't have to leave like a one-night stand and treat me like a prostitute. You could have at least kissed me goodbye. So, you know, now that's awkward and weird. All right, anyway, moving on. I try to give you the benefit of not knowing the timeline. I was just, you know, just one time she had to disappear for the day.
But she legit told me, like, her exact response and everything. So I'm like, I know part of this. Ha-ha, motherfucker.
Anyway, regardless. It's fine,
you're two floors above me.
Regardless, yeah, that's the only reason it's still happening at all. regardless, goddamn, what a story. That's unfortunate. I don't know how you put in 6 hours. And I like, too, that you said you didn't have time to go out for dinner first. But you put in 6 hours of work when you went home instead.
Okay, but, like, well, yeah, I guess they didn't have... I guess...
Bitch gets hungry after some time. She's going to start getting hungry and start chomping on a summer sausage. Even if,
like, sunrise starts at, like, 4 or 5 in the morning, he was still there at, like, 10, 11 at night.
Right. My goddamn, I know you wanted some dick, girl, but Jesus Christ.
Make them pay for dinner first.
Way too hard for that. You should have at least gotten a fancy steak out of it. Put some kind of meat in your mouth worthwhile. Goddamn. Fuck.
I bet the steak would have been more satisfying.
The steak absolutely would have been more satisfying. It would have hit the spot, unlike he, because he didn't fucking do shit. it wouldn't have required 6 hours to eat. You marinate a steak for 8 hours minimum, but after that, you can fucking chomp down on it in 10 minutes. The steak, fuck, I'm fucking hungry now. Oh, I can go
I have been hungry. I have been so fucking hungry for the last few days. Like, I go through these times where, like, I'll eat once a day and I'm cool. I'll go other times where I can continuously all day because I'm so fucking hungry.
Look what you've done, Faith. You started us talking sucking dick, and now we're talking about dinner. Which you should have got
first. Both goes in the mouth.
Hey, some goes in the genitals if you're a little explorative.
But if you're sucking dick, it's going in the mouth. Well, food sure. goes in the mouth.
What about that,
corn cob girl? No.
No, not corn cob girl. So I realized that we made a mistake last week. We did that video, that TikTok for the worst of humanity that was about that kid that walked in on his brother murdering a woman. And it was all text across the screen. So nobody heard anything other than the music playing out. And then the dude going, woo woo! So, I mean, you heard his side of it, but you didn't see the brother's text responses. So I apologize.
But we generally, like, discussed it, though.
Right, we did discuss it a little bit. What was said. So I do apologize for the people who are just listening. And if you do only listen, consider watching. And when we use things that are primarily more visual like that, like we're going to do today, I will tell you, hey, maybe switch over to YouTube or open your Spotify browser, whatever you're watching on. I don't know what other than Spotify shows the video. But
other than YouTube, too?
Yeah, other than YouTube. So maybe switch over to YouTube and watch this segment on YouTube, and then you'll get to see the whole thing.
You know what I just realized? All of our just listeners, not the people who actually watch this shit, miss all of my fun little
Like Faith watches?
Does she actually watch?
Yeah.
I love her
She brings
so
it up on her laptop. I don't know if she does it while she's writing or whatever. She should bring it up on her laptop, and she sent a picture a few times of our shining faces on it, so... Good on you, Faith. You don't miss a goddamn thing.
Love you, Faith.
Or bleep if we're calling you that. I don't know yet. We'll figure it out.
Bleep!
So this week's social media saviors has a video preceding it. Instead of an advertisement or a Facebook post or a Twitter post, whatever. So we're going to play the video first. And if you're ready to get into it, we'll just jump right in. Okay. Brothers and sisters, we gather here today to celebrate and give witness before the Sister Kate. Why are you involved in your cellular device and more than giving praise this morning?
Sorry, Father, it's just that Teresa is being a real bitch.
Sister Kate, we do not use that kind of language in a house of the Lord. What kind of grievous trespass has Sister Teresa inflicted upon you?
It's all over her page. Go look at her last post.
Now, it is important to remember not to judge others, for it is not our duty to do so, but to love one another even in... Oh, hell no.
Mm-hmm.
Congregation, open your devices to Facebook, chapter Sister Teresa, post 1. Now let us gather together and rain some unholy hell upon this wench. Amen?
Amen!
Alright, so you're familiar with this fella, right? You got the tattoos all over his face and his body.
I wasn't until you sent it to us.
Yeah, I did send you this video. And this is what he makes a lot of his content on, is just finding people who hate on him, investigating who they are, finding something deeply personal about them, and then tattooing it on their body. So we're going to watch this
He's
one.
He's done it more than once?
Oh, yeah.
Oh that's yeah. Fantastic.
I can't remember which one. Is this one the child one or the
the
father?
Grandpa. Yeah.
Okay. All right. There was one that was someone, he did a video about someone who got their kid taken away by CPS, and he did a tattoo of their kid's face. It said property of CPS on it. So let's go ahead and get into it then. And this week's, what are we calling it? I don't remember.
Social media saviors.
Because there's comments that
SMS.
I wanted to go through. SMS, indeed. It sounds like something sexual.
It's messaging, bro.
Shorties molesting shorties?
Bro, it's messaging.
I think a shorty's molesting shorties.
Ever since texting came out, texting has been SMS messaging.
This is why I don't drink while we record.
Why are you so dirty-minded? But, like, I know what, like, the...
We just talked about
I'm
a six-hour...
I'm so techie,
We just talked about a six-hour blowjob.
I don't want to hear your fair points, sir. Fuck you.
Watch the goddamn video.
Fine. God play it, damn. Bitch. Kara better leave all of that
This
in.
Is one of the nastiest, cruelest comments that I've gotten. It's a good thing that I am in recovery and that I've matured and I'm not even going to engage with this. Max, I was so devastated to hear the news about your father.
Hey, let all that get to my head. I don't care, I think it's how good. She devil, she bet, she removed, she can fool. To the pedal, it'll take a whole lot for me to settle.
I love his chuckle at the end.
So for those of you who refuse to obey commands and aren't good littles and going into YouTube as per... I wasn't going to cut a U, don't worry. Won't go to YouTube to watch the video segment. This kid is covered in like head to toe in tattoos. And every time somebody, like I said, cuts on him in one of his videos for being really sadistic towards people who are mean to him, he gets a tattoo of something deeply personal on his body related to them. So this guy, this guy commented on his video saying, "You're in recovery, LOL. Let's hope he gets back on the stuff and ends it all." So he dug through the guy's information and found a picture of his dad that he posted about, saying the last photo taken of my dad before he passed Father's Day would never be... I can't fucking talk anymore. The last photo taken of my dad before he passed Father's Day will never be... Oh my God, you read it. I can't fucking read words anymore.
The last photo of my dad taken before he passed... Father's Day will never going to be the same. No, it's not that you can't read.
I think Max is just stupid.
He is. Father's Day will never going to be the same again. Rip Pops. Hope I'm making you proud. Doesn't sound like you are, Max.
I thought I was having a stroke. I couldn't fucking read it.
No! He's just dumb. You're reading what it says perfectly fine.
But this photo, which shows a man who's clearly not doing well with the tube in his nose, got tattooed on this guy's body. And of course...
With the
Grim Reaper kind of hovering behind him.
Safe and all.
Naturally, being on TikTok... People are lovely people, and I wanted to capture some of these TikTok comments because I knew this video was probably going to get taken down, so I had to fucking jump on screen capturing these. So the first comment here says, "Bro, my jaw is locked from dropping so fast. Max is still crying. I just know." Another comment says, "I can't believe TikTok is free. Tag Max every Father's Day." Could you imagine tagging him in this reposted video every Father's Day as it keeps getting taken down?
That would be fantastic.
You couldn't get back on TikTok again. You'd have to just delete your account and never return.
No.
Oh, God.
This dude is petty to a level that is respectable.
Right. Next comment, "The Reaper's hand grabbing him sent me over the edge."
For people, no, I can't do it. I was going to give a demonstration for people who didn't watch it, but then again,
they wouldn't be watching it.
I can't drink. No. So, like, here's the thing.
Max rubbed
up on you. I can't drink because I'm dumb, but if I don't drink, I'm not funny. What do I do? It's also the brain cancer.
Okay, so long as it's all come back together then. Another user said, "That's not even my dad, but I'm even hurt." Another one says, "I'll tell you what he didn't do, survive." The internet is so goddamn petty to online bullies, and I love it. Another comment said, "Has anyone checked on Max?" I think Max found a closet that he can rock it back and forth in.
Max sounds a lot like Carl, who I shut up real quick.
Yeah, you love Carl.
I hate Carl. You know, I told him, we have proof, we have screenshots, we have receipts, you know, don't do this. And he kept going and going and going, I'm like, you know what, that's fine, I'll share it all. And he shut up, and then his buddy's like, okay, we'll go on then. So I gathered the proof and I posted it, and neither of them have said shit still. But, like, the random people are fantastic and they're joining the server because of it. Like, the one dude goes, "Imagine trying to trash talk a cluster and then getting proven wrong." Just make sure that they don't have receipts and proof first.
Here we go again, man, with the arc. I didn't mean to get you an arc, and here we go again.
You didn't mean to, and I didn't mean to, and it's only a slight arc rant, but it's still fantastic that people are calling this dude out for trying to cause shit and us being able to prove him wrong. It is just a fantastic feeling.
So, this is amazing. We don't usually get this while recording, but we got an update from Gerald.
Gerald!
Gerald commented... "Chain wallets, I need it again. I think he lost his debit card again."
Gerald!
God damn it, Gerald, do better. "I gave you the solution to your problems last week, or 2 weeks ago, and you fucked it up again. My man, what are you doing?" My second favorite comment, before we get to the best comment of all. Yes. It might be a little biased, but my second favorite comment: "Almost joined Max's father choking on my spaghetti." Internet's fucking amazing. I love this. I love that we were born at this time because we get to live in all of this. And this is why I can't get anything done ever, because this just fucking petty internet bullshit is so amazing. And then my last favorite comment, my favorite of all time, I couldn't resist getting in on the bandwagon. I said, "Max should be grateful. Now his father will live on, which is a feat he failed to do on his own." I love it so much.
Yours is by far the best.
And yet I didn't get any likes. I'm buried so far down the list, nobody gets to it.
What?
I feel so deprived of
it. It's like our TikTok. You know, we get so many views and yet we still don't have many followers. Go follow us on TikTok.
Indeed, follow us on TikTok. TikTok. I said TikTok.
Do you want to do some TikTok?
What is happening? What is happening?
I just said we can do some dick talk if it'll get some TikTok followers, but what the fuck is dick talk?
We need to get the fuck out of this before we ruin, like, we burn a hole in the universe or the multiverse or whatever we're doing at this point.
I don't have any advice for the people, though.
Oh, well, you better think of it. I'm going to buy you some time. You ready?
Yeah.
All right, cool. Thank you again for tuning in to another obnoxious and ridiculous. Don't look up anything.
I'm not.
Okay, you got it right off the noggin. You got this. I believe in you. Thanks for showing up for another episode that we wasted your precious hour of time with. We recently just finished a 24-hour gaming period in which we raised $100 for sick children through the Children's Miracle Network. So thank you for everyone who donated. For those of you who have not had a chance but still want to, you are perfectly able to. It runs all the way to the end of the year, I believe, if not at the very latest December 1st. But if you go to our Facebook page, just search us out at overdueforextinction.com. Not overdueforextinction.com. Overdue for Extinction in the Facebook search bar. You'll find our group, and we have a fundraiser through Facebook posted in our feed. You can go on there and donate still. And we have multiple tiers as well. I think for the $10 tier, you get a guest episode, one of which Faith will be on. So we got a plot with her about what time she'll be free to show up for that.
She's like 3 or 4 hours behind us.
Yeah, she's on the Pacific Coast. So you get that and a 20% discount to Crafting to Escape, which is my wife's Etsy store. You can either choose a... I'm jumping ahead of myself. Fucking alcohol is a bitch. For the $20, you get a free t-shirt plus the guest spot and a 20% coupon. The free t-shirt is either one of our podcast shirts, or Kristen has a wide variety of shirts you can order through her, or she will work with you. Did somebody yell at the window of that car?
No, I think it was music.
Oh, there must be blasting Celine Dion.
Anywho, I'm also helping Kristen with Crafting to Escape, and we make some awesome shit, and you can get a custom t-shirt if you decide to, what he was saying.
Yeah, custom shirt. You can work with Kristen and come up with a design she can make for you.
We make some cool-ass shit, though, and, like, we've got some temperature-changing vinyl. That is my favorite thing by far. Like, when we went in this morning... it was the cold temperature, but as bodies came in and it warmed up because of all the people in there, it did change to the warm temperature, and that was cool as shit, and it stuck on the warm temperature because of the amount of people in there, and I love that so much.
You're so easy to please.
And I'm also just selling right now.
And the last tier, the $30 tier, will get you all of that, in addition to a free year of our Patreon, which we kind of discovered through Faith, who subscribed or who donated, that you cannot actually donate Patreon subscriptions. So what we have done was we've created a Google Drive folder for which we will add you to permissions, and for a year, there's a fucking mosquito in my way. For a year.
You totally missed it.
No, I swatted it. It's cool. I'm a fucking ninja right now. For a year. God damn it, Kayla. Let me fucking finish this.
You will have access
to that drive.
Whatever it may have in it.
It will have at least one bonus episode a month, as well as our Patreon.
So many goodies.
As well as additional bonus content, including, but not yet made, random Omegle people that we're going to talk to and make do our segments with.
What are the chances of us finding Vlad? That's what I want to know.
Vlad so much.
One of the very few people who actually listen or watch our episodes should do the math for me, because I totally can't right now. My brain is broken as fuck.
If you want all other good content, where to follow us, where to find out if we have any announcements, you can do that on any of our social medias, all of which you can find at www.overdueforextinction.com. If you are interested in signing up for the Patreon, it's only $3 a month for getting the bonus content itself. We have other tiers, including a tier at $10 in which we will send a video message to somebody of your choosing. And if you want us to get fucking plastic, we'll do it for $10. We'll do it. We'll send a hate message. We'll send a love message. We'll profess your love for somebody who doesn't deserve it.
Write a poem that you want to send to someone and have us read it.
We will act out a skit of your writing.
Absolutely. Let's do it.
Someone's going to do that. It's going to be dangerous.
Let's do it. It's going to be Faith. Don't lie.
Well, for as low as $1, you can support the Patreon and get a shout out in an episode for it.
Like Faith. Faith.
Faith has just done this episode.
And as promised, she will get her bonus episode dedicated to her this month.
Yeah, sure she will. Alright, I think that's about does it. I think I've wrapped up all I can do. Follow us on all the places, donate to sick kids, help save some lives. Kate, what words of wisdom do you have to pass on to everybody this week?
Well, do you remember the other night when I was doing a thing on Kristen's computer and the program crashed and I was freaking out about it not saved? You were playing video games.
So it sounds sure like really I was, it attention. Sounds like you're confessing to watching sketchy porn that downloaded a virus. Go on.
No, I was in Silhouette and Silhouette crashed. Well, like, I was very concerned about my progress, and, like, we had to reprint the thing that I was doing, and I was very concerned that it was all lost and I had to do it again.
Mm.
All things not saved are lost, so save your shit as you go.
Save your shit as you go.
And as we've learned, make sure you have space for your shit, too.
And if you are doing a 6-hour blowy, make sure you take breaks for food and hydration. I think that about does it for this week, yeah?
Yeah.
Alright, stay safe and stay smart, dummies.
Still asking too much, but it's fine.
Overdue for extinction.